The thing that appealed to me most about the Manhattan Script is how rich and complex these human beings and their lives and their interpersonal relationships were with each other. You know, there's a great expression from the theater: if it ain't on the page, it ain't on the stage. And this was so on the page. I mean, it just leapt out at me. And you know, the guy who created it, Sam Shaw, did this brilliant thing where he, all of the facts of that time and place are accurate, but the characters are all fictional. So he was able to take this great leap of faith creatively and create lives and relationships and secrets and lies that are very much like the contemporary world. So it didn't seem like a dry historical drama to me. It seemed like very, very prescient and very, very cool and dark and mysterious and sexy. Are you kidding me? You think I paid attention to physics in high school? I was a child of the 70s. What I was doing at lunch, and then I would come back to science class, I was in no headspace to be studying nuclear physics. Yes, I was, you know, I wanted to be an actor. I didn't want to be a physicist. But one of the great things about being an actor is when you get a great job like this, you get to go back to school, you know, and I really immersed myself as much as I possibly could in theoretical nuclear physics. And also about this period of American history, which is one of the most epical and extraordinary moments in our nation, if not our world's history, because, you know, this is where we left that genie out of the bottle. Those men and women in this tiny little secret suburb in the middle of nowhere that the government created, they're the ones who gave birth to the modern world, to the atomic age. And it was the first suburb in many respects. So it was a crazy, extraordinary time and place to live in. Wing it. No, of course we had tutors. Yeah, because, you know, I sometimes I would catch myself mispronouncing a word. I would have to draw a lot of things on a chalkboard, and my buddy Jim Parsons, so brilliant on The Big Bang Theory, said, you know, just make them film you like dotting the I's and crossing the T's. you don't want them to see, don't let them see you sweat. You know, acting, it is make-believe and smoke and mirrors. So yes, there was always somebody close by who actually knew what was going on with the actual physics of the piece much more than I did. Oh God, that's a great, great question. I want to play a guy who rides a motorcycle. I want to do the Evel Knievel story. Probably a little old for it. You know who, we all know who Evel Knievel is, right? I want to play a guy who jumps over things on his motorcycle. Or, you know, if I can't do that, I actually would love to do a Western. And in some ways, Manhattan feels a little bit like a Western because we shoot so much of it out in the middle of nowhere in the desert. And so I love period pieces. I love Westerns. I grew up in Texas, big John Wayne fan. So yeah, man, put me in a pair of cowboy boots and a cowboy hat. That would be my next dream part. Yeah, we had 10 acres of the back of this, an abandoned group of buildings that were built in the 1940s, and we were able to convert it into our entire town. So we're completely immersed in that time and place, and nothing I've ever seen. It's like you have the entire backlot of a movie studio on which to shoot your TV show, and that's amazing.